Stage 2. It's Mr. Chambers here. I hope you're all well and safe, adapting to school life from home. I know that some of you are carrying on your instrumental lessons, and that's fantastic. But even if you're not, and you're still playing your instrument at home, we'd love to hear how you're getting on. So even if you've learned just one line of it, even if it's like a little snippet, a little small amount, or you've got a whole piece to play, we'd love to see and hear those. So if you could send those in to us as well, that'd be absolutely fantastic. And we can post them up on the music page on the website. The first thing we're going to do this week is to have a look at rhythm and pulse. Now, pulse is a steady beat. Okay, that's what pulse is. Obviously, you've got your own pulse, or two fingers on your wrist. And if you're sitting down, it should be nice and steady. The other pulse, which we see a lot of every day, is the second hand on the clock. That's 60 beats per minute. So that's another pulse. And then we have rhythm. Now, a rhythm is a repeated pattern. So we're going to look at a couple of rhythm patterns today. We're going to clap the dots. Now, as you can see, there are 8 dots in total. So with this is going to be a nice steady pulse. So we're going to clap each dot like this. Okay, that's 8 in a row. And if you kept on repeating that, then you'd have your steady pulse, okay? So this is rhythm number 2. Now, as you can see on this rhythm, there are some gaps. Okay, so this is a rest. So what you want to do, you want to rest for a beat in that gap. So for instance, rhythm 2 will go like this. So rhythm number 3. So again, we've got a few more gaps now. So we've got to rest a total of 3 times in this. Okay, so remember, you're clapping on the dot and then you're resting in the gap. Okay, here we go after 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now with this one, we're going to need the help of either mum or dad, parent, carer, sister, brother, to help you along. So you need 2 people to do this. So one person takes the top line and the other person takes the bottom line. Now, to demonstrate, obviously I can't be 2 people, but what I can do is play the drums. Hi-hat, this one here, is going to be the top line, and the snare drum is going to be the bottom line. Okay, so after 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. You can try and see how fast you can play them. With this one, where we have 2 dots in the bar, that means we're actually going to play them faster. So for instance, if I just clap for you the top line, it would go like this. Like that. Obviously, some of the rest squares are a little bit smaller, but it's still the same thing. It's still a rest for one beat. So if I now play both parts for you the same as I did before, so the top line is going to be the hi-hat and the bottom line is going to be the snare drum. So here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now we're going to look at something that we can do online using the idea of these dots and placements and where we can make a different rhythm. So I'm going to go to a different camera. Hi guys, and welcome back. So here we are on an online search engine, and you're going to type in Chrome Music Lab. Okay, here it comes. And you click on that. And it actually brings up quite a lot of things that you can have a go at,
lots of different games. And once I show you the first one we're going to look at, obviously, for this week, rhythm, you can look at other things as well after that. I'm going to, maybe at the next music lesson, we're going to come back and have a look at SongMaker, where we can do a little bit more advanced stuff. But first, for you guys, I want you to look at rhythm. So you're going to click on rhythm, and then it brings up this tab here. And if you just press the play button, so you can see what's going on here. These instruments here, these two instruments, are called timpani. Okay, so they're a type of percussion instrument mainly used in orchestras. And this one over here is a triangle. And what we can do, obviously, we've been reading two lines of dots, reading the rhythms, when to clap and when not to clap. With this one, we've got three, so we can create three lines of rhythm. And the same thing applies. So if you put a dot in, it's going to play. If there's no dot, so there's a little, tiny little grey thing here, but no colourful dot, that means there's going to be a rest. Okay, it's not going to play. So let's add a couple of things in here, and then we come up to the triangle, and then we play. Create our own rhythms and see if you can clap along and play as well. If you play a musical instrument or anything like that, you can set up these rhythms and you can play along to it. So this is a drum kit. Oops. So we can obviously just build up the drum kit like that. And so there's lots of wood blocks there, and the last one, this is my favourite one. This is the conga, the quinto, and the cowbell. So we can build these up like that. And as you can see, you can add things as it plays. Okay, so there we go. Have some fun with that.
I'm going to play you a little snippet of a probably more up-to-date track. It's by Billie Eilish, called Bad Guy. Now, from this section of Bad Guy, when the chorus kicks in, you can hear, obviously, the finger clicks on beats 2 and 4, and there's also a shaker going. Okay, but there's something else in the background. This is a good example of how you can, capture any sound and put it into a recording, and it's music. So in the background, you can actually hear, if I play it on this pad here. Okay, then that is actually a crossing sound. Obviously, when we cross the road in the UK, it beeps, but in other countries, I can't remember, maybe it's Canada, I'm not sure, they make this this sound, okay, to remind you that you need to cross the road, that it's safe to do so. So I'll play you this track now, and you should be able to hopefully hear it.
I'm the bad guy. Duh.
So that's a really good example of rhythm, and also mainly you can capture something and put it into a song, whatever it is. So, it'd be a good idea to listen out to different rhythms. The other listening piece I'm going to set you is a piece by Michael Jackson. It's called Don't Stop Till You Get Enough. Fantastic piece of music, and it's got a lot of percussion in it. You can hear a shaker going chicka chicka chicka. And then there's two parts. There's a cowbell part on the right hand side, and then there's a milk bottle, a glass milk bottle on the other side. If you fill bottles, glass bottles, could be any glass bottle, not just milk bottle, then you can create different pitches. from hitting it with sticks. And it's really cool. So this is Don't Stop Till You Get Enough.
You know, I was wondering, you know, if you could keep on, because the force, it's got a lot of power, and it makes me feel like that. It makes me feel like that.
Doing this, I can listen to it all day. So when you're listening to popular music or any music you listen to on the radio or favourite music at home, really this week pay close attention to the rhythm, you know, what the drums are doing, what the percussion's doing. That's it for this week. I hope you have fun. I'll see you guys next time. Bye.